Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel. Hope you guys are having a great day. Now today we're going to be talking about WB Games being broken up via AT&T's new merger with Discovery and the possible ramifications of what might be happening to those studios and even those future games in the process. So we're taking a look at this article from Gaming Bolt, and it says that WB Games is getting broken up as AT&T sells off most of its media business in a sales/merger with Discovery, AT&T announced today. Now, Warner Media, WB Games' parent company, will merge with Discovery to form a new company that is already being billed as one of the largest global streaming players. Now, I haven't really seen what Discovery has been doing lately. In fact, once they started doing the Ice Road Truckers thing, I pretty much stopped watching that channel entirely. But I think they may have actually been doing some things in the streaming space that are far more intricate and maybe bigger than what I'm led to believe. But anyways, let's keep going. AT&T will receive $43 billion in the sale. That's six times more than what Microsoft paid for ZeniMax Studios. That's honestly really big. I had no idea Discovery was going to be that large. And its shareholders will receive stock that will make up 71% of the new company. The sale is expected to be finalized next year. Now, WB Games is made up a lot of 11 studios. Rocksteady, NetherRealm, Monolith, TT Games, Avalanche Software, WB Games Montreal, Boston, LA, San Francisco, San Diego, and New York. Now, I'm very familiar with Montreal and somewhat Boston, but I haven't seen the games that LA, San Fran, San Diego, and New York have put out. I'm honestly kind of shocked that there were studios there. Maybe I'm just missing a lot of the games that they've been putting out from those studios, but I had no idea that they were there in that first place. But WB Games wasn't explicitly mentioned in the announcement, which could be kind of concerning or even not concerning at all. It could go honestly either way. But a spokesperson told Axios that the publisher will be broken up in some way. Okay, there's your bad news right there. As reported on Twitter by Steven Totillo, some of the gaming arm will stay with AT&T and some will go with the new company, the spokesperson said. It is currently unknown which studios will go where. So here is the actual tweet from Steven online. He says, WB Games is getting broken up somehow due to AT&T's Warner Media Discovery/sale merger. Some of the gaming arm will stay with AT&T, like we said before. There is, of course, no further info right now. WB Games lists 11 studios games for all kinds of IPs/devices. So here is where the rubber might meet the road. There are quite a few studios that are being put up on the chopping block or even set up to decide who goes where, and WB Studios may in fact be no more after this happens. We don't really know why or how for sure. But the big factor is there are a lot of games that WB has actually put out and has done through that arm, and I'm honestly wondering what's going to happen to those games in the future. I mean, when you think about their library of games, you've got the Arkham series, Middle-Earth series, the Injustice series, Mortal Kombat series. A lot of really great high-profile games are coming from that publisher and WB in general. And I'm wondering what those studios will be doing in the future and how they'll be recuperating from this loss or this merger or this sale. I don't know why I said lost in the first place, but I guess they could be in fact lost or shuttered if they don't get chosen between either AT&T or Discovery's new company. This could be a larger ramification of what actually happens in the games industry as more companies and developers and publishers are being bought and sold, creating an oligopoly of actual companies owning a very large amount of developers and/or publishers controlling a majority of the gaming space. I've talked about this before in my ZeniMax buyout from Microsoft, but that doesn't mean things are going to be as bad as they seem. They could go incredibly bad, but we don't know for sure until the actual rubber meets the road. But let me know what you guys think in the comment section down below. Do you think this may be something that honestly destroys a lot of really great franchises and/or developers throughout this actual merger or sale? Or do you think that Phil Spencer is gonna swoop in and buy everybody out and then keep everything on Xbox? Because that's really been one of the big things we've seen online, is people just memeing about Phil going in, just opening up that Microsoft wallet and buying everybody out, which could possibly happen. You never know with that guy. He's honestly insane. But even then, that would continue to strengthen my argument about the oligopoly approach with Microsoft and other companies. Let me know what you guys think. I'd love to hear your feedback, and I'll try to respond to you guys from out of nowhere. I stole that from WrestleTalk. Yeah, I absolutely did. Now, if you like the content and you like the video, please subscribe. It does mean a lot. If you want to see more of me, you can check me out on Twitch and Twitter. It's at, oh no, it's Alex. Do you want to join the Discord? Yeah, I bet you do. The link is in the description down below. Thank you so much for watching. I appreciate everything. Hope you guys have a great one, and I'll see you next time.
Fucking bullshit! Son of a bitch! Bullshit, Joe Hogan!